All right, so start of a new session. I believe where we left off is we just barely walked into this building and talked to the waitress, which notified us that Heidi, the one we're looking for the council or chamber of commerce, whatever it's called, is off at a funeral somewhere, which we also heard from when we went into the brothel itself. But that's going to be one of our goals to proceed, because everything's been pointing at that one character, but I don't think I finished exploring this place, and I'm sure we'll have more people to talk to, so we'll do that first. By the way, good news, everybody. This game has, for a while now, been in the same time slot for my schedule as Fallout 4, but I just finished the story of that game, so if everything goes according to plan, no promises, I guess, if everything goes the way I want it to, I think we're going to have daily episodes of this game now until its completion, because the game that it was alternating with is now done. And then once both are done, I'll have a whole chunk of my weekly... of my daily schedule
Wowza,
cleared out.
Where did you spring from? What a beauty!
Swifty's being scummy over here, apparently.
You got a bright future in this town, kid. I can see your name in lights.
Yeah, how can you not trust something that looks like that guy?
But out, jerks. I'm in the middle of a very important meeting here. You're... Say, that's quite a face you got there, kid. Anyone ever tell you you got star power? I mean it. You really got something.
All right, where's the nearest tub we can drown this guy in?
Listen, I'm in the middle of something right now, but here's my card. Come to my office. We'll talk. Maybe do a little screen test. See what happens. Okay? Great. Ciao.
Oh yeah, and what's your job?
My job? What does it look like, chump? I'm a star maker. I make stars. You ever been to the Chinese casino? Half the girls and boys in that floor show come out of my Rolodex. And half the kids at Heidi's, too. I'm the guy with the talent for spotting talent. Now, do you mind? Thanks.
Kids, boys, girls?
Kids equals boys and girls, which equals talent. Get with the lingo, chumps. This town runs on beauty, and I've got the best in the business.
Oh yeah, and what do you know about the slavery?
I don't know what you're talking about. Hey, no need to break my arm, but you got it all wrong. These yokels don't understand the scope of my business. They think Hollywood is the only place they can make it. Bullshit. There's dance halls and casinos all over the place. Las Vegas, Pechanga, Reno. And I place boys and girls in every one of them. All these punks running around saying that so-and-so disappeared. They didn't disappear. They got a job in Vegas. Now, get out of my face. Okay, okay. For you, I'll check my records. Meet me later at my office, and I'll see what I can find. You know, you got star potential.
I love that works. I just ask the same question over and over again, and it works. Look for my place near Rat Boy's out on the street. You know where to... All right. So we're gonna go for his place near Rat Boy, and we'll hear about the slavery stuff he might know about. Might be a trap. He's asking us to go somewhere that's not public.
Like I said, come by my office soon. I think you could be the next big thing. Ciao, baby.
Well, at least we scared him away from preying on this lady. Who can I talk to them? Nope. Hello, store. What can I get you, honey? Something for the drugstore? What do you have? Just called a wait, I'm sorry. The screen says waitress, and the icon is somebody with like a Fallout-style gas mask and hood and AK-47 out in the desert with maces. Like, that is quite a gap between two images. Alright, snake squeezums, roasted scorpions, and beer. So, all of your intoxication needs. Can I sell anything? Nope, didn't have any. At least pressing the scrap button didn't give anything. I could sort through my inventory to sell, like, jackets and nonsense, but don't feel like doing that right now. Howdy, folks. What y'all's doing back here? Kitchen? Howdy, folks. I just said that. Whoops. What can I get you? Tell me from the drugstore. What do you have? Soda jerk. And, oh, they actually sell medicine, at least. That's noteworthy. Advanced trauma kit. Master trauma kit. Military grade... I could use a couple of, trauma kits. We've been burning through some of those. So I'll just grab some of those for later. They'll inevitably be needed in some way. Carefully examining the door, Sally finds a locked code panel. An industrial airlock door used to keep things in, things out, and secure passcode. What can I see about these people? It's just two people standing behind there. Are they armed? Can't quite tell if the other person's armed or not. They look, I mean, I could almost see these two people being trapped here. Like slaves. Let's go meet with the leader, the, Swifty. Let's go meet with him first before I do anything back there. Cause that might matter. That might matter. Alright, so looking at our map. It said next to rat. Rat. Swifty's office, that's close enough. Oh, we're on the opposite side. Wait, where am I? So go slightly north. Where's my compass? There we go. North and then over east. Should take us right to Swifty's office. Someone, we're being attacked. What? Oh shit, my party's not here. Everyone's gonna catch up. Die, piggy. Alright. I accidentally stayed in single character mode. So... Oh look, they teleported in handy. I was worried for a second there. Alright, let's fuck up some pigs. More fuck up of pigs, go! Damn, that's some damage. I meant to target somebody else, but it's fine. Let's see. Can I reach any of the pigs? There's just some girls. I can go become adjacent to a pig. Oh, but next up is, Scary Sally. I'll go over here. So if needed, I'll be ready, but I think we're good. Well, I found this. I think I found the cemetery. I somehow managed to go around the entire town in the exact pattern that would not lead me here. So that's kind of impressive. In a failure sort of way. Hello. Sally angry. Sally crush. Sally have giant ridiculous hammer. Now that that's over, we can get on with this. Darling, or Darlene, or as we called her, Farah, had a soul, beautiful as her perfect sculpted cheekbones, and the absence of her warmth and kindness will make our house something. Let us pray that the men who did this, those vicious thugs from God's militia, burn in hell that they believe in so passionately, and may their cocks rot like month-old blood. God damn it. The voice actors don't speak anywhere nearly as fast as the text moves in this game, in these sequences, so I really wish that... First, it's weird that it's not voice acted. They seem like important characters, but anyway, it's weird they wouldn't just make them take a little longer or let you affect the speed of it. Oh well. Anyway, there's a dead prostitute. She got killed by God's militia because they have obvious dislike for that kind of people in general, because they're scummy. And I think somebody just might have gotten enough experience to level up again because of the sound I heard. I'm not sure. I'm waiting for my characters to actually get hurt first. Especially since we're prepping for a big... Like, there's clearly a conflict between God's militia and,
No and thanks, piggies. We don't want any.
They surprised me a little bit. There's clearly a conflict between God's militia and the locals here, so I'm figuring that at some point, we're probably gonna have a big fight between those two, so it seems like the ability to level up between fights to instantly heal everybody would be really handy. What's this? Ten Commandments of James King. A small laminated card with text printed on big black letters. I think that's a new one for me. Usually on this character, right? Yep. A primer for children. 1. I am the Lord your God, and James King is my prophet. 2. To deny God is the greatest sin. Those who do not believe must be delivered unto God for judgment. 3. You shall recognize no other church than the Church of Salvation. 4. The teachings of God, James King, and the Church and... Take the teachings of God, James King, and the Church and spread them onto the land. Those who believe will follow. Those who do not will fall beneath the Lord's vengeance. Stay not your hand to cleanse the unbeliever. Read your Bible daily and pray to the Lord God and his prophet, James King. To commit adultery is to sin. To allow intoxicating substances inside you is to sin. To lie and steal is to sin. Only through cleansing the sins of others can you cleanse your own sins. Yep, they suck.
No
in general.
Thanks, piggies. We don't want
it. Okay, you keep... You have voice acting, clearly. What do you say?
This is the People's Republic of Hollywood. No pigs allowed.
Pigs?
Are you kidding me? The weapons, the badges. Never trust a uniform. That's my motto. You're nothing but another band of fascists. No different than the HCC or God's Militia. Why don't you go beat up some junkies?
What does Republic of Hollywood mean? This looks like a hobo jungle.
Spoken like a true pig. This is the only true safe place in Hollywood. A shelter for the homeless and the runaways that all the rest of those slimy fucks prey on. We keep them safe from people like you. Now get out of here.
He mostly seems like one of those obnoxious people that calls people sheeple, basically. The way he keeps calling everyone a pig. What do you have against salt?
I got nothing against taking drugs. If you can handle your shit, do whatever you want. But salt, it's not a drug, it's a plague. You take enough, you don't come back. No amount of rehab will clean you out. You just shuffle around like a zombie for the rest of your life. It's killing my kids.
What do you know about the slavery in Hollywood?
Huh? Try again?
Nothing, really? Okay. Well, you're an outsider, tell me about the HCC.
Hookers, casinos, and crooks? Oh, I'm sorry, I always get that wrong. Hollywood Chamber of Commerce? They want us to think that they work for the welfare of all Hollywood, but they only protect their own business. They put all their money into keeping the tourists happy and fighting those God's Militia freaks. There isn't one penny left over to help the people who actually live here. We can all go die as far as they're concerned.
Not a crazy concept when you have two factions that are basically capitalism versus religion. Neither of them in their pure form is really going to be the most helpful thing in the world, is it? What do you know about the God's Militia?
The only good thing the HCC does is keep those wackos out of Hollywood. This town may be corrupt, but the militia are religious fascists. They worship some sledgehammer messiah who preached that the only good sinner is a dead sinner. I'll be honest, they scare the shit out of me.
What if I ask about the salt again?
If I knew where it was coming from, I'd firebomb the place. But it seems to come out of nowhere. They deal it out of the Hotel California, but I've had kids watch the place day and night. Nobody leaves, nobody makes any deliveries. Hey, if you managed to wipe that filth out at its source, you would be doing the kids of Hollywood the biggest favor of their lives. I might even change my mind about pigs.
Whatever. What a great guy. He's so great. Love that dude. What's that little piece of dialogue there? Oh, that's literally what he was just saying. When I only saw the bottom part, I saw the word firebomb. I'm like, it almost seemed like some kind of environmental description. It was not. Doing a quick glance around. Hello. Johnny Maloney looks exactly like my sniper. Let's not dwell on that. Name's Johnny Maloney. You need a grave dug? Oh, hey. You could help me with some beasties. Beasties? Don't know what they are exactly, but they're sure making a mess of this place. Tearing up the graves, eating the bodies, it's terrible. I can barely hold them back. I ain't even et in a few days. What? Okay, fine. I'm so hungry that I could eat a painting of a sandwich. You dig graves? That's my job, digging graves. Making coffins too, if you need one. Just tell me how big you want it and pay the price and I'll dig you something nice. Do you need help? Well, why not? You look like you're handy with a weapon. You clear out this little infestation of mine. Don't go messing with untouched graves. You dig up any of my customers and I'll give you a couple of shots at double out buck. Come back to me with all the vermin cleared out and all my graves unmolested and I might throw you in something extra. Okay, so how do we go ahead and quick save then?
Do you find it lonely work?
That's why I took it. Had enough of loudmouths wanting some peace. Alright. Little dialogue back and forth. Where is this vermin? I'll just go charging in with this character. Hello. That's just a grave. Oh hey, vermin. Friend. No, go hit them. Oh, do I have to approach them manually? Oh, they noticed me. Line of sight established. Oh, look at them forming two perfect little ranks of three. Ow, 20. Oh. They had enough AP to attack and then move, and then it didn't. Well, oh, hello. Haven't seen one of those for a while. Cool, he missed. Please don't take my weapons. Oh, there's two of them. Those are bad. They can steal your weapons right off your character. Didn't mention them losing the weapon. Does she still have her... Yeah, she still has her mace. Okay. Let's focus on the toads first. Damn. Oh, that was less effective. I guess the first one was a crit then. Oh no, it doesn't say crit. It must have just been the sheer damage range of that attack. Alright. Oh, melee characters in the back. Awkward. Well, let's go hit the guy that's closer to death. Finish him off. Not quite. Second hit. It's a good thing he can attack so many times. Oh. Whoa. Whoa, camera. I slightly tap the joystick and it just shoots off all the way over here. They have some interesting implementation. Weird problems like that are extra interesting to me now, because at this point we're talking about being like several patches in. Or at least they've had time to do several patches. So the weird issues are just strange. Oh, there's one way back there. I figure the biggest threat's the toads because they can take your weapons. So I'm focusing on them for now. Down. Let's see, does this attack have a flurry of attacks? If it does, I don't have the AP for it. Here we go. Ooh, surprising amount of damage there. Alright. Looks like I should have been reloading earlier though, because I'm running out of AP, out of all that right now. Let's see. Well, I could move around, but these characters are already right on top of me, so I might as well just hit them, right? This one's closer to my teammates. Bring it down! Ooh, sad dog noises. Oh. It's like they evolved to make you feel bad. Zero damage, never mind. Not going through that. First fire, I'm out of AP already for that. No, go back to normal attack. There we go. That guy. Just sort of pecking away. See if I can aim this just right to hit a few targets at once. Maybe not. Alright, we'll just shoot him in the face then. Or unless I can aim across like this. No, that's apparently going to hit my teammate somehow. How is that not hitting the toad? It goes straight through him. Anyway. And that's a miss. I'm kind of impressed right now. Alright, I don't know if I'll do enough damage to hurt the toad, so maybe I should focus on the beast over here instead. There we go. That amounts to something. They're getting their follow-up turns. Yep. Even this crowd is picking away at Sally. Ow. They can do some actual damage. Alright, let's see if I can finish off the toad. That's the path you're taking? Oh, I guess the other path was blocked by tombstones and nonsense. So that was probably the best you could do. Well, you're on top of my teammate, so let's go for you. Oh, try again. That's better. All right, now things have the scales have tipped significantly, and we're down to three enemies. Oh, all that drama, and it did a tiny peck of damage. That's a durable enemy. Does he have more hit points than the other ones do? Doesn't look like it. See if we can finish this one off. Cool. And we're empty. Oh, but I still have enough AP to shoot, I think. There we go. That's handy. Get him, Sally. Hit him with a giant mallet that's like the size of his head. So that his head collapses. These guys are also worth a lot of experience. I can't help it. I just constantly compare how much experience everything is worth. I really should have burst shot. I don't know why I did that. I compare how much experience everything is worth to how much experience it was worth for me to do the Scorpatron. There we go. It's really just because that was like the big tough fight. Oh shit. Heal. There we go. I saw Gus bleeding out over there. I'm like, oh crap, heal, before he just flat out costs me another med kit. How much longer is his bleed gonna last for? 30 every 10 seconds? Oh, jeez. That's still like another 300. Okay, can I heal? I wish that wasn't in real time when I was in that menu. That's frustrating. The real time element's rough, because there's definitely moments of like, I would sure like to be able to navigate my menus and see if I have the thing or not. Nope, I have no bleed staunching stuff. Alright, I'll just have to heal him then. What do we got here? Toad Eye, Wolf Paw, Tattered Pelt, Toad Eye. Cool. There's a safe back here. Interesting. Wow, he's going down fast, by the way. That's a significant bleed. Where is he? Oh, Ayrton's also bleeding fast. Crap. Small medic pack, just to top him off. Damn you, real-time damage. Ayrton. Come on. It's gotta run out soon, right? How's he doing? Oh geez, minus 41 every 10 seconds? That's even worse, that's like 400 more damage. Not quite, like 300 more damage? It's pretty shitty. Shit. Oops. Am I on Ayrton now? Yes. Pick him up. Ah crap, I wasted some time and I'm gonna be in some trouble here. I really should just go find a hospital, but here I am trying not to, here I am trying not to just use a revive item. This is probably not the smartest way to handle this. But I don't have any bleed fixers right now. Fuck me. Why does it say 40? No, it's just a huge amount of time. Holy crap. Is there like a... Is there a doctor? I don't even remember. I don't remember there being a doctor. Or where it was. I may just have to let this happen. I don't know if I can keep saving Ayrton like this. Well, he's down. Will his bleed at least wear off now? What does that symbol say? Dandali can only be revived with surgeon skill. He's still bleeding. Jesus. This is silly. Wow, he's straight up dying. And I only have advanced trauma kits. Wait, no, I can use this other character. He should have better, different trauma kits. Basic. He's about to straight up double die. Be all the way gone. Ah, the bleeding's gone. Wow! Okay, that was severe. I don't know, I could have probably handled it better, but... Fuck me, that was not... That's not a save? That's an alarm? Why did I click on it? I'm sorry, I guess I was just distracted by the whole bleeding problem. I didn't think to just deal with that. If I run away, maybe no one will notice. Well, I did what that guy wanted. Let's get a reward. Hopefully he doesn't freak out about the fact that I touched a safe for a second. Who's that? Oh, it's you. Thanks for coming. Sorry, I couldn't talk at Schwag's, but Duke only likes us to talk about happy stuff when we're on duty. What do you know about Schwag's drugstore? I hate that it's become such a pit of wolves, but a girl needs a job, doesn't she? Or don't she? At least I can try to tell the new kids what to watch out for, right? Even if sometimes they don't listen. Ah, see, look what you did, I'm crying now. A little advice for you, don't go into Schwag's office. He gets mighty mad when people do. Don't go peeking at his lockbox either, I saw him cut a man's hand clean off for that. The wolves? They're all over this town, feeding on the poor lost sheep who come here dreaming of the Hollywood dream. Slavers, pimps, and psychos. I don't know why the HCC doesn't do anything about them. Old Heidi's hot pants says she wants Hollywood to be a clean shop, but the scum are still here, year after year. What do you know about Heidi Hollander? I don't like Heidi much, but she runs a clean place and keeps her boys and girls happy. A kid could do a lot worse than working at Heidi's. Not as big as the Chinese casino. Talk about her hideaway this time. I thought I was repeating the same question again, but I'm not. Not as big as the Chinese casino, but they offer more services, if you know what I mean. Dancing and cabaret up front, and then in back, you can have your pick of any boy or girl you saw on the show. Best brothel in the world, I bet, if that's what floats your boat. What do you know about HCC? Hollywood Chamber of Commerce. Most businesses in town are members. They chip in to pay the street cops and the cost of fighting the pistol-packing priests. They're pretty good at keeping the tourists safe, but they don't seem to care much about the street kids. What do you know about the God's Militia? God's Militia, they call themselves. I call them nut jobs on the hill. They think every sinner in the world should be chopped up into little pieces. Well, it's if killing's a sin, they're the biggest sinners ever. Come down at a Griffith Park just about once a month, killing everything they see and taking their stuff. A crusade, they call it, and taking tithes. It's straight up robbery and murder. They're the ones who should be chopped up into little pieces. Glad you came to find me here. I gotta head back to Schwag's now. Shift's about to start. Alright, so that was relatively uneventful, that dialogue, but they definitely had her come down here so that I would talk to her, specifically because it would take me past the funeral that was going on over there. So what's gonna happen if we talk to you now? 2012 Gauge ammo. I can't hear any more beasties out there. Well done, strangers. Let me get you that reward. Now, where did I put it? See you around, strangers. God's Militia giving me too much work, but everything's fine otherwise. Hope so, those bastards. Alright. Hey, we finished up two little quests there. Might as well investigate this safe we found back here, since it doesn't seem to be too much of a big deal. Oops. That was me pressing share on accident. Here we go. My bad. Oops, didn't mean to do that twice. Let's see. Safe cracking is 26. Alarm disarm 0. No one's prepared to do that. I could give it a shot, but it's probably going to critically fail. I pressed start then select and accidentally opened the share button because of that failure. What happens is I've been playing a lot of Dragon's Dogma lately, and in Dragon's Dogma you press start then select the quick save. Critical failure, it's broken. Alright. How about the repair chance? Garbage. Alright, well, we're moving on with our lives. Another safe that I haven't opened properly. If I had a dime for every safe I failed to open, well, then I'd probably have about the net worth of all those safes that I've failed to open. Safes and giant armored doors next to giant cannon-based bosses and stuff like that. Alright, let's head over to the office. They said not to go to the office, but I'm gonna head over there anyway. That's what's happening. I should level up some characters, too. Whoa. Oh, Swifty's right here. Hey, it's the Stars. Good to see you. Looking fabulous as always. Well, let's get started. First, why don't you put your clothes in that trunk, then get comfortable on the couch while I load the camera. Now, where did I put that film? Stars? Really? That's right, kid. You're going straight to the top. I can tell already. In fact, I already got a job lined up for you. Yeah, that's why you're telling me to strip already. Oh, really? What's the job? Modeling gig. Client wanted something new, young and fresh, and you are just what the doctor ordered. What do you know about the slavery in Hollywood? Welp. We found it. Well, it's a bad time to be our entire party of harmed characters. I really should have healed up properly before coming in here. Well, we're gonna be using another trauma kit. Hey, friend. How do you feel about having fewer organs? Chop chop. Yeah. Talking quite literally at the moment. Oh, you're gonna pick a fight with Sally. Be my guest. Oh, the two of them are picking fights with Sally. That helps our survival chances for sure. Let's see, that's... Oh, 21%. Who am I playing as right now? Yeah, it's Bezeppi. Oh, he's behind cover is why. Well, this guy's in the open, so screw him. Oh, that doesn't work that way. Anyone conductive? Are they all conductive? Can't... Yeah, let's just shoot him. It's not much, but it's something. They have a lot of hit points, though. 500 each. Alright. Take a knee for better accuracy. And there's not a lot of cover around here. Okay, Sally's taking damage. It's definitely a bummer that, Hey, you. Definitely not good that, Gus went down immediately. But I didn't know we were walking into a fight that fast. Or we would have prepped a little bit more for that. 50% chance of shooting. Not the best. Let's get to cover. Help our accuracy chances in general. Might be able to finish this guy off. Should I do a flurry of attacks? So he has 95 hit points. Might be able to take him out with individual shots. Nope, didn't amount to much. Oh wait, I had flurry highlighted still. That's my mistake. Whoops. Alright. What if I just walk right up here and I shoot you in the face? That sounds like fun, right? Maybe I can hit you both at once. Maybe I should take a step back. Wait, oh yeah, I can't do the AP right now. I'll be out of AP in a second. Let's just shoot this guy in the face. Okay, I'm really starting to get blown away by this character's inability to hit anything ever. Hey, stop that. Ooh, attack of opportunity. That ends poorly for you. Oh, he's alive. That's a surprise for me. This character's really far away. Burst fire. Let's see, I need to get this much closer to hit him. Now we're in range? Oh, we're not in range still, huh? Alright, one more. Now we're good. But not enough AP for burst. So regular attack. There we go. That takes out a chunk. Hey, friend. There we go. Feeling good. Can't reach the slaver, so let's take cover. Because the character's not doing great at the moment. Hey, you. No, stop it. Sally can only take like 10 more hits like that, and then she's gonna be actually in trouble. Ow. Okay, that's getting bad, actually. The gun is more dangerous for obvious reasons. Bezeppi, keep working on this guy. Definitely gonna try to find a hospital after this. Hey, oh. Actually damaging. Not a fan. Finish him. And then we're gonna get real up close and personal with this guy. Make him feel uncomfortable. We're out of range, aren't we? Son of a bitch. Always seems to happen to me. Okay. Slightly closer. 1 AP. Burst fire. Screw you! Wow, you just aren't the most effective thing in the world. He tries, right? He tries. Alright, Dolores, let's see what you can do. Please hit somebody for once. I believe in you. Please. Holy shit, how is that possible? She hasn't hit a single target with like her last 10 attacks, I think, and it always gives me a decent success chance, I think. Alright, burst fire. Alright. At least Pizeppi's relatively safe now. We might lose Sally.
Feel the wrath of the Dark Lord.
Oh, what are you doing? What the fuck? If you're gonna steal my turn from me, at least hit the target, or even attack somebody. He like swung his weapon at the wall. Idiot. Can I attack again? Yeah. Ooh, Sally angry. You got some good shots in. Now Sally gets some good shots in. And down. Alright, well. We took care of the slave problem, everybody. No big deal. Winchester 20 megabyte hard drive. the last hard drive you'll ever need. No one is ever going to fill up a full 20 megs. Crumpled greenback. Who's this Franklin guy? Alright, let's heal you up again. You poor, poor characters are just having a bad day right now. I only have an advanced trauma kit? Someone's gotta have a regular one, right? Basic, yeah. Advanced just seems extreme for fighting a regular, picking up the sniper with a low health cap. I try to use advanced on my melee characters who have a lot of hit points. Alright, everyone reloaded? We've had a tough day. But hey, now there's no slave problem around here. Now we just need to find out where all the drugs are coming from. The fact they said that one person said that the drugs, they don't see anyone coming in or out means that they must be coming from inside the building, like they're making them inside the building. Maybe there's a monster or a mutant or some weird thing going on in there. Everything seems conceivable. Yeah, have I seen a doctor around here? Let's see, Ertan, man, woman, rat boy, Sean Bonsky, Donner Brothel, recruiter, dungeon, camp. Oh, right. Now I remember. The drugstore. The drugstore has a medic. That'll top us off. Then I'll probably level up and wrap up the episode there. And we'll finally meet up with HCC and stuff like that. And make progress towards what's going on in this region. We took care of a few things. We met the main person, or at least we found the funeral and proceeded with the story there. Had a few fights, and took care of the slave problem, more or less, by killing at least, like six slavers, I think? Alright, heal me up. We need it now. Alright, everyone's feeling way better. Let's start looking into what we need for leveling up now. At this point, with Gus, he maxed out outdoorsmen and sniper rifles. He's got some points to spend. I think leadership's the thing to go for. Because I can't get a lot of good perks for, most of the trade skills are basically accounted for at this point. But at leadership, yeah, reduced chance of followers to ignore orders, increased chance to hit of nearby allies and stuff. Like, he's usually in a totally different location in the party than Sally is. And so his leadership will actually benefit different characters at different times, potentially. And he could also act as a backup whenever Sally goes down to help people like Ertan from, betraying us. And, well, not really betraying, but, you know, going against orders. So that should be a decent backup thing to put points into for this character now that he's kind of out of things to put points into at this point. Sally just hit level 30, so she actually gets a new attribute point, and we don't have any more strength to give her. Charisma's definitely, seems worthwhile because of the, leadership radius. Let's see if any of these options would specifically give her a different action point. It just doesn't see. Here it says level 8. Intelligence? No. Do I have a perk that makes. Oh, wait. I think I have a quirk that makes me have permanent level 1 intelligence. That might be why. Because I was noticing it doesn't say what happens in the next level. I just want to see if anything gives me a bonus AP. And they do not. Chance of bonus AP during combat. One combat initiative is not terrible, but I think charisma just for the increased radius is decent. That seems like a decent idea, especially since her quirk is that she can reduce the attack accuracy of enemies that are nearby. And as a combat character, they tend to be nearby. I mean, as a melee character, they tend to be nearby. I can go further into leadership. I'm really shocked by how low level blunt weapons is. Let's see. 40% and 16% at level 6. I have a bonus, so it's a little hard to properly quantify this, but yeah, I think I'm gonna go further in. Don't know how many more level ups we're gonna get. This might be one of the last areas in the game before the big showdown, actually. So you have 12 points to spend. Oh right, I think she was high on her point count last time, and then I couldn't afford what I wanted to afford because everything's really high level for her for the most part, aside from things I don't really want to put points into. So, she can really invest. Do I go further into healing, for example, or lockpicking? I mean, she's the only lockpick, so let's not neglect that. a double into the lockpicking, that'd be pretty good. I'll go ahead and do that. Seems reasonable. It's also tempting to go further into things like kiss ass. Always mixed feelings there. Pistol, yep, Pernell's 29. Next point to handguns. That's what we were saving for. Now he's finally maxed out at that. Oh, he has a perk point remaining. Does everyone have a perk point? No. I think he's had a perk... Wow, I haven't spent hers either. I'm gonna go for that bonus AP from light armor. It's a handy little chunk of AP. Oops. Go one over. I think Pernell's actually had another point to spend ever since level 26 and I somehow missed it. Oh wow, chance of a free attack goes all the way up to 12% with handguns. That's handy. That's actually a decent percent chance of getting a free attack. Alright, Pizeppi. 31. Oh, she has an attribute point left from last level. Given the options I see here, I notice that strength is right on the threshold where the next point's gonna give her plus one constitution per level, which is not normal. That'd give her another 30 hit points plus the plus three base, so it's like 33 additional hit points? Yeah. That's a pretty noteworthy leap forward. Almost like second in line after the idea of getting a bonus AP, so I think I'm gonna go for that. Where are we on skills? She's so high in smartness that it seems pointless. Yeah, energy weapons. Let's help her accuracy. She's been missing. A little more than I'd like her to, at least. Air 10 also has a point to spend. Probably in strength, but I'll check for AP bonuses. Oh, next point of coordination gives me bonus AP. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go for that coordination. That could be the difference between having an extra attack each turn or not. So plus one AP it is. Even though strength is preferable for the current weapon he's using. I think the AP difference can make a bigger difference. Let's go into bladed weapons a bit more. Obviously worth putting more points into. We'll commit for now. I was previously saving up for the next point of heavy weapons, but I haven't... The ammo consumption is a serious problem that I cannot fund. Wow. A lot of characters have AP to spend. This one is pretty straightforward. He's already a shooter. He's already one of my shooters, and high coordination's helpful. So getting plus one AP as a reward, also handy. So definitely going for that. Anything that helps my character shoot more times per turn is going to be a big help. Let's see. There's a perk for surgeon, expert physician. Might be worth investing in. They're both valid, but this one giving me access to a new perk probably just tips the scales a little bit. But he has no perks to buy right now. He'll have another one in two levels. Right, it's 28 and 32. So Airtan only had his, Pernell only had... He'd only been able to buy a perk for like two levels at that point? Or like one level. Who was it? Was it Air 10? I don't know. Somebody had a level at the wrong time. It's fine.
Let's trade, my friend.
See you, Rangers.
Do you have anything that'll make women do what you want?
Just love, man. Just love.
You mock me at your peril.
Ayrton, you jackass. All right, before we close out the episode, let's just go ahead and visit the diner. Hear what Flo has to say about the fact that the creep is dead. It was right over here? Think so. Oh, yeah, right here. It's a relatively large area. At least it's easy to navigate, unlike the rail nomads. Stupid slaughter. More lambs to the slaughter.
Like a sheep farm run by wolves.
Okay, Thomas, we got it with the first line. It's okay. Hi, Rangers. Good to see you again. What do you know about Swifty? Real piece of work, that one. Keep your eyes open for anything. I might be able to bring the HSP to, on him. I'd love to get him gone. Well, he's dead. Are there still people back here? I'll do a quick save, but let's see if I can investigate back there. Or if it'll get me in some trouble. Let's see. Computer science chance is pretty low. I'm going to try anyway. Ha 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 ha. It explodes. We all die horribly. You critically failed at computer science. Time to become a geology major. I swear to God, I'm just gonna beat this door down.
move over. This is my specialty, which is why I'm going to fail at it multiple times until I break it.
Can you even critically fail at computer science? What happens if you critically fail? Like, you rewrite its operating system so no one can interface with it anymore? On a door? Oh, critical failure, it happened. Alright, well, I can do this. Hey, friends. I'm gonna move in now, don't mind me. Please don't break your leg. Hey, asshole, what do you think you're doing? Howdy. Hi. Did I hurt myself just now? She's got a star on her leg. Tortured tootsies. Ugh. She succeeded and hurt herself, apparently. Hey, everyone. A murky room with a big desk and a safe on the floor and TV monitors that show views of the restaurant and kitchen. Through a door and one wall. Oh, we're fighting now. I thought we were gonna talk about it. Wait, Duke Swag? Oh! I mixed up Swag and Swifty earlier is what happened. My bad. I thought I took out Swag already, but that was that random guy Swifty. Swag's a totally different person. My mistake. Well, who's the most dangerous person around here? Could be any of you, really, huh? Well, I have line of sight on you. Let's shoot their leader. Maybe they'll give up. Probably not, but he's very hurt now, so that's fun. And my melee character's trapped behind all of my non-melee characters. That's also fun. Alright, I guess I'll conserve AP. Bummer. Here they come. Oh, they always gotta target my sniper. Why can't you guys ever take on- Oh my goodness. Why can't you guys ever take on a fascination with, like, my, one of my melee characters, huh? If I get this guy, maybe we can get him before he gets a turn. He's down to 152 out of 650. The chance of hitting is so bad, though, that it seems kind of pointless. Hey, neighbor. How do you feel about point-blank range? I'm feeling pretty confident about it myself. Hola. And crushed. Not quite. Alright. Let's go just cage this guy in over here. Hey, friend. You're my new best friend. Alright. If I move back here, I can just pummel this guy, right? 100% chance of hitting. Bye. And he lived. One day, Purnell, you'll know what it's like to damage things with guns. Let's see. I don't want to block my melee character from getting in, so let's go over here. And then take a shot like... Oh, 22 is pretty bad. But this'll hit my teammate. I can go for this guy, 72. Hey, we hit a guy. It's possible. I proved that it's possible. Oh, no. Poor guy. Wow, he's dead. Just like that. Jesus fucking Christ. I didn't even know we were gonna have a fight. I'm loading. That was abrupt. I mean, I knew something would happen, but I thought we might talk first. There was an abrupt change there. But anyway, at this point, I'm pretty happy just to go in and attack them, because Swifty basically confirmed that they're in the slave trade, so fuck it.
You're my new best friend. Whee!
So now that I know what we're getting ourselves into, the configuration makes way more sense. The way that my entire party got forced along the wall like we were a fucking execution happening in progress was kind of a rough way to start a fight. The exact moment where turn-based combat starts and ends and what tiles they force characters into can be very interesting sometimes to experience. Howdy, folks. I'm the sniper. My primary characteristics are that I'm far away. Only person in line of sight. Maybe I should move in with this character. Take couch cover. Hello. Finish him, maybe. If you don't mind. I guess you minded. That's fine. Sally's here to end people. One giant cinder block swing at a time. Bye. Ow. Talk fast, asshole. What the fuck do you think? It's gone. What do you think you're doing? There we go. Mostly trying to murder y'alls. I don't know, you immediately started shooting us when we came in here. Which, to be fair, we broke down your door, so it makes sense. But also, slave trade. So this is like the... This is like when the authorities and their windbreakers come charging in to deal with your bullshit. You had this coming. We know what you're doing. Alright, come on in. And just blow them away. First fire. Yeah, you tried. Most importantly, I can do this. Let's move slightly over, because now Sally has space to come in. If they have time. And we can just carve away. Their leader is durable. Attacking him first last time was probably a mistake. Still going down, though. Alright, Gus, we are not going to be able to get a shot off, are we? Oh, we can. Cool. Perfect line of sight. 200 more experience. We just got showered in experience. 400, that's half a Scorpatron. I'll always compare it to that, just because that was such a big deal of a fight. A proton axe? Let's go send that to you, see how that turns out. Seems pretty crazy. Spectrum Assault Vest. The Infernator. Upgrade shotgun, probably. And a med kit. Alright. How's that med kit gonna work for... It's a shotgun. It has to be an upgrade, right? I haven't upgraded it forever, have I? Hoplitz Problem Solver? Oh, I think I might have gotten this as a reward recently. Either way, the Infernator's clearly better, so... Let's go ahead and grab that. Equip on primary. Mods. Remove the choke mod. Removed. Cool. Now field trip it. Strip it. More parts. Tactical shotgun. I think I got this and forgot to compare it. Doesn't matter now. It's not modded right now, so we'll just go ahead and field strip it. Less weight. Alright. You. Mods. Choke. Reduced cone angle plus range. Both reduce the... I don't know if I want to choke, honestly. The chance of hitting more guys at once might make it worthwhile just to not have a cone in the first place. The other thing we found was an axe. How does this compare? Proton axe. 1.2 higher damage without grip tape. So it already has higher damage per hit. Higher armor penetration. And after modding, it'll have the same AP cost. Yeah, it's just a better item. Alright. Cool. I was kind of hoping it would be better because it's a freaking proton axe. Just seems like a cooler concept. Let's see if we can remove the grip tape. We removed it. I think I'll just dismantle this one. There we go. Alright, grip. How high is that attack per AP going to be high now? 43.2. Let's compare that to what's going on with Sally. Yeah, he's got a better weapon than the makeshift mace now, if you can apply it properly. That's some scary shit. Well, it makes me happy I took him out. Spectrum Assault Vest. Yeah, I've got the pseudo-chitin. It's 7 armor with 0 downside. At this point, I think I want to throw in a sniper just to make him stop going down, because he's such an obvious target for how effective he is. 4 armor? Yes. Yeah, let's send you over. Make our sniper very hard to kill. So this is a 4 armor. Does someone have something worse than that? I think 4 is our minimum right now. 5. 4. He's got the mobile infantry armor. Yeah. A lot of the party has 7s now. That's becoming increasingly common. Let's look around for something that'll indicate that he's the bad guy around here. There's a lock and explosive trap on this thing. But I think you're over-encumbered, aren't you? Oh, right. Let's just send you over to Sally. Now we can walk again? Cool. Alright. Throw in a quick save. This is probably a long episode by now, but I just wanted to follow up on this before going anywhere else. Demolition's chance of success is really low. That's, you have it too? And an alarm, wow. Just all over the place. Let's give him a shot. I think we're falling behind on the explosives upgrades, so this might just blow up in his face. Please don't kill the people behind the wall with the explosion if we can avoid it. Failure. Let's do single control just to avoid accidentally having people walk over here. I believe this safe's probably what's gonna have the incriminating evidence. Alright, well, it's still locked, but now it blew up. So that's fun. Alright. How about you? 20% chance of success. What could go wrong? A lot of things are gonna go wrong here. Ow. Well, that happened. Hey, lockpick person. Let's take a look, huh? Now that that detail is taken care of for the moment. Hey, a minigun. Only slightly terrifying. We'll send that to Ayrton. Oops. Forgot that that means also we're controlling them right now. That's a low success rate. Good luck. Alright, we had a failure. We had a critical failure, so I'm thinking, what if I do something nasty here? Please don't kill anyone else in the building. Minus 100. Is it broken, though? Duke Swag's ledger. Hard evidence of the Duke Swag slavery activity. Ooh, there we go. I can show this to two people that want it. No special information there. Alright, everybody go! We had good happen. Hey, you. Duke gave us no choice. We had to take him out. He was the head of the slavers, and I worked for him all this time? Ugh, I want to puke. Wish I could make amends somehow. Huh. Well, maybe I can. The place is gonna need a new owner, ain't it? Maybe I can make it what it always should have been. Thanks, Rangers. Everything's on the house for y'all from now on. Everything? Like your medical supplies over here? Are these on the house? No, they're not. You're a liar. You lied to me, and I'll never forgive you. Alright, let's switch back to my sniper rifle. Everyone make sure you're reloaded. Alright, any follow-up here? You took over the drugstore? Oh yeah, she says, welcome to Flo's. For you, everything's on the house. You name it, it's yours. You took over the drugstore? Yep, I know the sign up top still says Swags, but I'm the owner now, and it's all thanks to you. You got rid of the boss, you got rid of the slavers, and you gave me the chance to give the old place a new start. No more wolves and sheep, just good clean food and happy people. Thanks, Rangers. Y'all come back now. There's a weird quirk in the dialogue where she wasn't all like, whoa, what happened, or anything like that. She was basically just non-reactive to the fact that several people were firing firearms and then exploding in the next room over.
A brothel. Brothels are
Welcome
cool.
Welcome to Heidi's Hollywood Hideaway, where your pleasure is our pleasure. I'm Heidi Hollander, at your service.
Hey, Heidi is actually here to greet us this time. Not going to talk to her quite yet, though. I'm trying to follow up on the slaver thing first. So you should be right over here, right? This was like the dark side or whatever. There she is. Hey, we found the thing you wanted. Have we found any proof of slavery yet? Yes. Let me see it. Yes, this is perfect. Now please, take this to Heidi. Show it to her. She'll have to listen now. So we're good then, right? Yeah. More experience. Oh,
baby,
oh wow.
And you shall be spared.
We already have two characters ready to level again.
Before me, that I might choose.
I think I will wait to use them as a healing opportunity, though, once again. Alright.
I want to bathe in the blood of the innocent. I want to hear the lamentations of the women. I want... What? Her? No. I'm the one that does the hitting. I'm the evil one.
I love that. It's almost like people are realizing that Sally's just a more badass character than Ayrton is. But he does have a crazy laser sword, or laser axe now, so who cares? Or who knows, but I think I'm gonna go ahead and cut it here, guys. So we took care of the slavery problem in town, and we got Heidi back to where she's supposed to be. So next episode, we'll finally, I think, get progress towards dealing with the central conflict here. Thanks for watching like always, and I'll see you next time.